Hello friends, in this section we shall see how to pass the data from an HTML form to the CGI script. In HTML or using HTML, you can create a form for user's interaction. User can enter or select certain data. There are different kinds of form elements by which user can interact with the software or with the program. For example, there can be a checkbox element inside the form which allows you to select one or more than one checkable items. So the form gives or provides one or more than items which can be checked or unchecked. That is called as a checkbox. On the other hand, the radio button is such an element which has more than one options, out of which only one can be selected. Text area is, there is a text box and text area. Text box allows the user to enter one line data, and text area is something in which the user can enter multi-line data. The drop down element in the form is such that it is a list of items which are contained inside a drop down box. There is a small arrow and on the right hand side of it. As the user clicks on it, the other elements are visible, out of which one element can be chosen. So such different form elements are there. What I will do is I will show you a demonstration of how to use, first of all, how to create these elements on the HTML form, then how to send the data that is entered by the user using these elements to the the CGI script that is running on the CGI script of the web server. So these are the four different options or four different videos that I will show one by one as a support to this. So now I will show you the use of checkbox and how to send the data selected by the checkbox to the CGI program. So what do we have in this HTML script? There is a form in which there are two checkboxes and then there is a submit button. Checkbox, as you know, gives you a selectable button. The status of the checkbox is either on or off, right? And this form data is, because the action attribute of the form is set to the checkbox.py, this Python script will be placed in the CGI bin directory, and the method is equal to post. So what we will do, we shall put this HTML code in our document root directory of the Apache server and open this form in the client browser. So the checkbox.html page, which is in the document root, is now opened on the server and it is now displaying two checkboxes and a button. So we can perform, or we can choose the two provided checkboxes in any which combination that you like. And then we shall now press the submit button, which is captioning select subject. So when we press the submit button, what will happen? This form data will be redirected towards the CGI bin, Python script, and that will be processed. So what is that script that is running in the background that we have to see? So this is the Python program that we need to put into the CGI bin directory of our Apache. In order to retrieve the form data and process it, as earlier, we have to import the CGI and CGI TB modules, create an object of the field storage class, and the object will contain the form data in the form of a dictionary. So remember that we had two checkboxes. So the values associated with the two checkbox names, maths and physics, all we have to verify whether their values are on or off. And whatever the values of those have to be, rendered back to the client page in the form of the HTML that we have written below the Python code. So this is of course the mandatory statement which is needed for the Python script to be qualified as a CGI. The content type is equal to text under oblique HTML, and this is generating the HTML in which the status of the two checkboxes, math checkbox, whether it is on or off, those status values are stored in these two variables. Math flag will be either on or off. Physics flag will be either on or off depending on what was the selection made at the client's end. So this is the background script that is running. So we'll now go back to that client, send the data and see the result. So coming back to this HTML form, two checkboxes and a button, make your selection and send the data to the Python script by pressing the select subject button. The Python script in the background will respond the output back to the client like this. There it is. The status of these two buttons is now reflected back in the form of HTML rendered by this checkbox.py, which is inside the CGI.bin. So this is an example of the processing of a checkbox in CGI. Welcome back. Now the next demonstration is of how to use the radio button which is created on the form, and the data chosen by the radio button is sent to the CGI program. How that works, I will show you the demonstration. Now this HTML code, it has a form, and in the form there are two radio buttons and a submit button. Because the two radio buttons have the name attribute set to subject, this means what? The two radio buttons will be mutually exclusive, in the sense if you select one, the other will be automatically deselected. Now this form, the action attribute of this form is set to radio button.py Python script in the CGI bin, and the method is post. So we shall put this HTML page into the document directory of our Apache and open it in the client. So this radio.htm is now opened in the client browser, and it is now showing these two radio buttons and a submit button. As I told, these two are mutually exclusive, in the sense one will be selected, the other will be automatically deselected. So when I submit this button, when I click on this select subject, this form data is going to be redirected towards the radio button.py, which is on the server's CGI button, CGI bin directory, and the method is going to be used as post. So what really is the underlying script that is running in the background, that we will see, and we will analyze what the code is about. This is the code of radio button.py Python script in the CGI bin. As always, you have to import the CGI and CGI TB modules, create an object of the field storage class. That form object will contain the dictionary of the data that is received from the client browser. So we had only one form element and whose name was subject. So we have to see whether the subject attribute is set or not. So that can be ascertained by form.getValueSubject. that is equal to subject. So that means either it will be either physics or mathematics, depending on what selection has been made. If not, then the subject value of this variable subject will be equal to not set. This is of course again the mandatory print statement which renders the content type is equal to text oblique HTML, and the rest of the HTML will render the value of the selection or selected subject from the client. Okay, so this is a simple Python script that is running in the background. So we'll go back to the client's form, submit the data, and see what result this Python script sends back to the client. So coming back to the client browser, in which the HTML form has been displayed and two such radio buttons and a submit button is generated. I have made one selection, and then I will press the submit button. That form data will be posted to that radio button.py and it will render the corresponding output. Let us see. The selected subject is maths. This is what the radio button.py script says. So this is how the radio button data can be, you know, rendered to the CGI script that is written in Python.
Welcome back. The next demonstration is of the use of text area in the form, the data filled up by the user in the text area, how it is sent to the server, and how the CGI program receives it and processes it and sends back the result. That I will show you with the help of a demonstration here.
Now, in order to demonstrate how the text area data is sent to the Python CGI script, we require an HTML document in the document root of the Apache server and a Python script in the CGI bin directory. So this is the HTML page in which there is a form, and inside the form there is a text area, and then there is a submit button. Text area is different from the text field in the sense that in the text area you can write multi-line text. So in this document I have created a text area whose name is text content, and the size is columns 40 and rows 4, and then there is a submit button. So this is how the HTML page with text area and a button is created, and it is stored in the document root of our Apache server. So this text area.html, which is now stored in the document root of our Apache server, and it is now opened on the server localhost colon 8080 is the port oblique text area.html. So this is the text area that is visible. We can type any text in this multi-line text. Something like this. And now if we press this submit button, this text in this text area will be posted towards the CGI bin directory, where the text area.py file will intercept this data and process it. So now we will have a look at that backend script. So I have placed this text area.py. This file has been put into the CGI bin directory of the Apache server, and as per the requirements of a Python script to be treated as a, you know, CGI script, we have to start the printing by this line, which will ensure that the output rendered to the browser will be in the form of HTML. So before actually rendering the output, first we have to import these two modules, CGI and CGI-TB. The field storage class of this CGI module, that will store the form data that is posted from the HTML form. So form is equal to CGI dot field storage, and then there is only one element named as text content. So the contents of these text content element will be fetched by the get value function of the form, and that is rendered as an output using this print command. Okay, so this is the content of this backend Python script in the CGI module. So the form of the HTML form will post the data to this, and this backend script will process it. So let us go back to the web page textarea.html, which is present in the document root, and it is having a form with two elements, the text area and a submit button. Text area is nothing but a multi-line text box. This is the text that has been entered into it. If I press on submit, the data will be directed towards the textarea.py script in the CGI bin directory. There the field storage class object will contain all this data, and from that form object the data will be fetched and rendered back to our client browser. So let me click on this and see the result. There you see the server is confirming that the entered text content is "Hello, how are you? Welcome to tutorials point." So that is how the text area data is sent to the Python script working as a CGI script here.
Welcome back. The last demonstration in this series is of the drop-down element on the form. There is a form in which there is a drop-down containing more than one elements. The user will select one element and send it to the CGI. How the CGI script processes that and sends back the result, that we shall see with the help of a demonstration.
So how to send the drop-down data from the HTML page back to the CGI script? So the HTML in front of you contains a form in which there is a drop down element whose name itself is drop down, and that drop down is populated with two strings, val is equal to maths, val is equal to physics, and in addition to that there is a submit button. This is of course the manner in which the drop down is created in the HTML. The data is proposed to be submitted to the dropdown.py, which is set to be the action attribute of the form, and the method is set to be equal to post. So we'll put this HTML page on the document root of our Apache server and open it in the client's browser. So the dropdown.html is now opened in the browser. This is the drop down that is created. There are two values populated into it, and then there is a submit button. So the user will make a proper selection and the submit button will be pressed. As soon as it is pressed, the data is going to be posted towards the dropdown.py in the CGI bin. So in the CGI bin, the Python script in the CGI bin will retrieve the data and do the appropriate processing. So we'll have a look at the dropdown.py. So this is the script of dropdown.py in CGI bin. As always, you import the CGI and CGI-TB modules. Then create an object of field storage class. This form object will store the dictionary of the form data. As far as this form is concerned, there is a drop down HTML element, and the value associated with that is to be stored in a variable called subject. So if the value, the selection has been made, the selected, you know, subject like physics or math, whatever, that will be stored in the variable called subject. Otherwise it will be set to not entered. Again, this line is necessary to qualify this Python script as a CGI executable, and then the rest of the HTML is what it is doing. It is rendering the result back to the client browser. It will be displaying selected subject is, if the selection has been made, or if not, then it will print not entered. So this is the script which is running in the background of that client form. Now coming back to the browser and the form that is displayed in the browser with one drop down, these are the two entries. We will make one entry and press submit. This data will be processed by the dropdown.py in the CGI bin directory, and it will render the result back to this. The selected subject is physics, that is what this dropdown.py says. So this demonstration is for sending the dropdown data to the CGI script using the post method.